Eritrea has been described as the North Korea of Africa. According to the UN, more than 500,000 Eritreans have fled their country. Some say 10% of the population, including many Christians. Most churches were forced to close in 2002, and many Christians have been arrested and detained indefinitely. Some have been brutally tortured. As with most totalitarian regimes, what drives the repression is the desire for control.
Christians have been the most persecuted group of people in Eritrea. It's because they wouldn't stop their gathering, they wouldn't stop their worship. It's beyond the government's control and beyond the government's expectation, because Christianity continued to grow in Eritrea.
In recent months, many Christians have been released, causing some speculation about a possible change of heart. But then some Christians were rearrested.
I don't see any change. And the government always say boldly, we haven't changed our policies. The government is not gaining anything by arresting these hundreds of Christians. Even the government is losing a lot by feeding them. So please release them. Their families, their children, their wives, their husbands need them.
Many Christians have fled to neighboring Ethiopia, whose refugee camps offered safe haven until civil war erupted in the Tigray region. Eritrean troops have joined in the fighting, which has been marked by brutality and has caused famine. It seems that Eritrea is exporting its brutal attitude towards Christians to Tigray. In November 2020, Eritrean forces killed up to 800 civilians in the sacred city of Aksum, including, according to Orthodox Church sources, at least 78 priests. And a former prisoner of the regime, Helen Bahani, says the killing of Christians is continuing in Tigray.
It's overflow from Eritrea to go to Tigray, and they kill a lot of priests. Some of them, they stand with their cross, so they cut their hands. They ask them to remove their hat. So when they say no, they shoot them. There are hundreds of priests die in this conflict by Eritrean soldiers. Also, priests' wife, they rape them. I don't know why the world is silent. I don't understand really.
Helen Bahani was imprisoned in Eritrea for her faith. She was locked up with other Christians in a shipping container in the desert, baking by day, freezing by night, and she was tortured. So what sustained her?
Always I'm praying, singing, also I'm reading my Bible. Also, if the situation is very extreme, harsh, I fast, not to change the situation, but to discipline myself and to understand the situation. So I ask God, what's going on? Yeah, I found encouraged words from the Bible. So that's why I encourage people to read their Bible. We are in hard times, so we need to fast and pray.
We pray for protection for all these Christians who are still in Eritrea, and pray for grace so that they could receive with joy all the suffering, because they are doing it for the sake of Christ.